Hello students, welcome back. Now we will see the application of operational amplifiers. What are the application of operational amplifiers? The application of operational amplifiers are something like peak detector, zero crossing detector, or zero crossing detector. Then oscillators. These are the important application of operational amplifiers. We'll see now the first application, how the peak detector works. And this is the diagram for peak detector. What we have in the diagram? So before proceeding here, so I will isolate this diagram from this one, and I will try to explain you. This contains an operational amplifier. This contains an operational amplifier with the resistor. And we have diode, and we have capacitor, and we have resistor. Once again, this is used for discharging. So other than that, we have one resistor in the feedback path. So the value of R is very large compared to value of R1 and R2. R1 and R2 is very small, so that discharge will take long time. So this is the circuit diagram explanation. Now how this works actually, we have to see. For that, let me draw the input. So let us take, I have the input something like this. So this is the input, and it starts from zero. This is the peak of, this is the peak, and this is the peak. So my output should be, it is something like, it has to detect the peak of the detector. This is my output. Output should be something, it has to detect the peak of the detector. This has to detect the peak of the detector. So now initially you will take this output is zero. Output of the capacitor is discharge, fully discharge, and it is zero. Now what we are feedback, what we are feeding zero voltage to the non-inverting inverting terminal of the operational amplifier, but input is generally greater than this one, because input is generally greater than this one. That's why output of the capacitor, this one, operational amplifier becomes positive, and this will forward bias our diode. When the diode forward bias, there is a path will establish for the current flow, and that will charge the capacitor. So now this will continue, charging of the capacitor will continue until it reaches this peak. Suppose let's call this peak as V1. Until it reaches V1, when it reaches V1, after that you can see the input decreases, the value of the input decreases after that. That means now the input at the non-inverting inverting terminal is V1, and output, that is at the voltage at the inverting, is decreasing. That means for negative is greater than positive. That will produce zero output at the operational amplifier. Zero output of the operational amplifier will reverse bias this diode, and our capacitor will start to discharge through this resistor. But here we have designed the resistor value in such a way that capacitor will slowly discharge. That means our capacitor will, from here it will slowly discharge, almost it will remain same. And when once again our input becomes greater than this V1, this is V1, right, greater than this V1, output of the comparator becomes I, and that will forward bias the diode, and that will once again recharge the capacitor, and capacitor will continue till it catches the new peak, So our output is something, if I start from here, this one is new peak, and this will catch the new peak, something like this. This is our output, or otherwise this is our peak. This is our peak detection in the signal. This is our peak detection signal. This may go something like this, and depending on the signal, this peak may come down also. Please note, here we are trying to detect the positive peaks, not negative peaks. So this is the way our peak detector works. But now the question comes, what about this circuit diagram? This circuit diagram, because of this I input impedance, this will act like an isolator for our capacitor, or it acts like a buffer for our capacitor. So this acts like a buffer for our capacitor. So this is about the peak detector.